say, dance for me, dance for me, dance for me, oh, oh. I never seen anybody do the things you do before. They
then
say,
you go to Seoul, Korea. For those of you who are familiar with this logo, this is the Shake Shack logo. And today we'll be trying the chicken sandwich from Seoul, Korea. I'm going to go into as to why it's called the chicken sandwich from Seoul, Korea. It's a limited time only. And let's go ahead and do the unboxing so I can describe to you as to what makes this chicken sandwich different from the typical Shake Shack sandwich. So again, obviously, as I mentioned, this is available in the Seoul, Korea Shake Shack locations. But just recently, they are now offering it in the U.S. for a limited time only. So let's go ahead and do an unboxing. So this is what the sandwich looks like. If you notice, there's a type of coleslaw on the bottom. And let's open it up a little bit. So the chicken is marinated in some kind of red sauce. And let's go ahead and read the description, which is on the back. So it's a crispy chicken sandwich. As usual, you know, Shake Shack likes to advertise that their meat is no antibiotics, hormones. And this is the sauce. It has the, again, I'm not sure the pronunciation, gochujang, spicy, sweet, fermented umami. So it's got to have a lot of flavor. It also has kimchi, which is tangy, crunchy, napa cabbage, daikon, fermented, meaning I believe that they let it rest in a bowl or something to ferment before it's ready. So of course, what we want to know is, what does it taste like? So you can see the cabbage underneath, we can see the chicken, you can see, even though it's a fried chicken sandwich, they didn't not too much batter or what have you. So some people like that. Me, I like to go somewhere in the middle. But again, without further ado, let's see what it tastes like. So what does it taste like? So despite the appearance of being dry, it's actually moist. Not juicy moist, but moist. Despite the fact that it says spicy, it's actually more on the sweet side. The kimchi is a nice touch. So sweet and tangy is how I would describe it. The chicken is moist, but not super juicy, but overall delicious. Again, if you're looking to travel to Seoul, Korea, and you were thinking of trying their, I guess, specialty sandwich that's not available in the United States, this is one way to do it. Is that top of my list as far as chicken sandwiches? Sorry, Shake Shack. I'm still going to have to go with Popeyes as the number one chicken sandwich as of now. But it is delicious. Something different. The flavors are there. It's, like I said, sweet and tangy is my best description. A little spice, but they didn't get, you know, that gist of it. And it is delicious. A little bit on the pricey side for a chicken sandwich. If you check the menu, you'll know what I mean. So again, thank you for watching. Don't forget to click the subscribe button. Click like if you like the video. And of course, let me know what you think. Let me know if you're planning to try it. Not at all. What your favorite chicken sandwich is. But again, this is for a limited time only. Again, I don't work for Shake Shack, but just want to let you know that, you know, that's what got me to it, where it's something different on the menu for Shake Shack. They do have the chicken sandwich. Please go ahead and watch my review. I do have a video on that on the way. So I did try their spicy chicken sandwich at Shake Shack, and the regular one as well, I believe. But this one is the again, specialty chicken sandwich from Shake Shack. Normally only available in Seoul, Korea, but for a limited time only, it's available in the U.S. Thanks for watching.